favorite ones, welcome to Soul Reflections. Happy New Year! My gosh, it's now 2022. Grabe, ang bilis ng year. Para siyang isang iglap. And a lot of things happened in 2021. Well, at least for me. A lot of things happened and all of them were really, really huge gifts and blessings from God. But right now, I'd like to talk about practicing kindness and compassion because, you know, I find myself talking to more people who needs consultations. Okay? You all know that I've been doing counseling, and counseling is different from giving advice because in counseling, the aim is to heal whatever it is that happened in the past, whatever trauma that a person has gone through in the past, and, you know, find peace at the present moment. The counselees may find action points or decision points to make, but then that's up to where a counselor really steps in. But you know, this week, I found myself talking to people who are seeking advice, and it's so different from counseling. So it's more of a consultation, and at first I was kind of uncomfortable because they were already asking, you know, for ano ba yung gagawin, and I was like, the answers are all inside of you, it's just that we have to draw it out. But you know, my realization is that not everyone can really think for themselves. The more questions, the more clarificatory questions I ask, the more confused they become. And it made me realize that there are really some people who need advice, who need guidance, rather than, you know, just me asking the questions for them to know the answers that's already inside their heart. And you know, at first, I have to admit, I was kind of off. Parang sa kapat ganyan, but hindi marunong mag-isip. And ano, I just had to realize that not everyone can really think for themselves and need more help in terms of making decisions. And that's what I found myself in right now. That's why the topic for today's session is practicing kindness and compassion, because you can't really go wrong when you practice kindness and compassion. Yun lang nga, we always have to discern if the kindness and compassion that we're giving is actually the correct one. Because being Filipinos, we have this cultural conditioning to be martyrs, to be victims, diba? Yung bigay na bigay na bigay. But then, that's also not right. We also have to find the balance. So if we're practicing kindness and compassion, we have to make sure that it is the correct kind of compassion, it is the correct kind of kindness, without stepping on our own selves. This is where, I suppose, experience comes in. This is where prayers comes in, discernment, even meditation, because you know, we wouldn't want to hinder the growth of another person by being too kind, by being too compassionate, because that's no longer kindness and compassion. A person is here, every soul is here to learn, to grow, to experience life. And if we keep on babying another person, it hinders their growth, and that's a bad mark to us. Okay, as helpers, it's a bad mark. So there's a balance to being kind, compassionate, and applying wisdom to it. And that's where I found myself this week, to in my consultations. Actually, consultations na nga siya. Hindi na nga siya counseling. Kasi talagang they're really seeking advice. Directly asking, how should I go about this? And of course, what I have to do is ask them what it is that they really want. And then from their vague or general answer, give them a specific task so that at least they would be able to do something and try it out if they know that, for them to find out if what they're doing is actually what they want or not. Kasi hindi mo naman malalaman kung gusto mo o hindi, kung hindi mo susubukan, di ba? Lalo na kung hindi mo talaga alam. So, that's where I found myself, being kind and compassionate to people who are not used to thinking for themselves, who are not, who has not experienced life extensively yet. And of course, a lot of wisdom comes into it because I cannot just give advice then and there. Talagang kailangan pinag-iisipan siya na mabuti. And, you know, that's where I'm coming from right now. That yes, it's good to be kind and compassionate, but hindi naman pwede na nakakawawa naman, di ba? We also have to consider that another person has to grow in this life. And in growing, they also have to experience things on their own, diba? So, ayun, it's a combination. Being kind doesn't mean just saying yes all the time or giving in all the time. There are times when we have to say no, we have to stand for what is actually right. And that is also considered kindness to another person. Example ko na lang would be, you know, when I was younger, I was so afraid to speak up. I was so afraid that other people would judge what I would say or others would counter what I would say. But then it came to a point when in my silence, I was suffering. Diba? Nagtitimpi, hindi ka magsasalita, and then you're repressing, suppressing every emotion. It's you're not expressing it. It's really bad for your health. And I'm not just talking about physical health. Yung mental, emotional health mo, napaka-fragile because of that. And that's when, you know, I learned to speak out. Diba? I didn't do it immediately, parang isang one snap at a time, biglang nagsasalita na ako, expressing myself. I did it slowly. And by the grace of God, here I am, talking about my life experiences, doing lives. When I remember the first time that I did a live, I was really having cold sweat. Kasi nanginginig ako and I was sweating. Cold sweat talaga siya. So, because I was expressing myself in social media and I don't know who would be able to hear me, di ba? Sino yung nakakarinig? And I don't want to hear anything judgmental or negative because my confidence was so fragile. But then, through time, I just talk. And if another person doesn't agree, then that's it. So be it, di ba? That's just take it as that. It's nothing personal. There's just a difference in opinion. There's a difference in belief, in value system. So it doesn't really matter. And, you know, at the end of the day, you have to be kind and compassionate to yourself more than anyone else. Of course, diba? That's where wisdom would come in. How do you be kind? How do you become kind and compassionate to yourself while being kind and compassionate to others? So that's where wisdom, prayers, discernment, meditations come in. And you know, during this year, this coming year, I pray that all of us would have the wisdom to practice kindness and compassion, to understand what compassion is truly all about. And it's really not about the being a victim or not being a martyr. Hindi talaga yun. I pray that we all find compassion to ourselves, which is also equivalent to self-love. Ayun, so God bless everyone. This is ewan ko ba napahaba ata, 15 minutes ata ako nagsasalita. But thank you so much for watching, for listening. And if you know anyone who needs consultations, okay, I'm available. I'm opening up slots for that. I find myself growing as I talk to other people. As you all know naman, diba? I do soul talk and I love interacting with different people because, you know, knowing the stories of other people helps me grow as well. And I suppose I learn best from other people's experiences. So do let me know if you know someone or if you yourself would need some consultation, do send me a message. I would welcome any messages or any hi hellos from you guys. So God bless everyone. Take care.